I love JoJo characters and it is time to rank them. Hey guys, it's your boy, the boy Tvay here. And welcome to this video where I rank all the important JoJo characters from F to S. Because how else would I rank them? Anyways, I decided to make this video in two parts because I ended up talking for too long. So, without further ado, let's get into business. First of all, we have Jonathan Joestar, our very first JoJo. He's not as cool, I mean I made a video on him like 2 weeks ago. But now I have to compare him with the other characters in JoJo. So, I'll put him in D tier, just to start this tier list. And now we have Dio. Dio is S tier. I mean, he was there in all the parts except for Battle Tendency. And he has one of the coolest stands in JoJo. And he's the first one to kiss Erina. And he confirmed it to her face. Yep, he's definitely S tier. Now we have Speedwagon. I freaking love Speedwagon. I can put him in S tier, but that wouldn't do him justice. Wait a minute. Let me make another tier. Yup, he belongs here. And now we have Erina Pendleton. I like Erina. She's not as lame as everyone thinks. She gets a lot of hate. I'll put Erina in D tier with JoJo. And now we have Baron Seppeli. Seppeli was not that good. I mean, he wasn't even killed by the main villain. But he has one of the best scenes in JoJo when he sacrificed himself with the ending music in the background. I'll put him in E tier. And now we have Joseph Joestar. Joseph Joestar is cool. He knows when to fight and when to pull out. I would put him in a higher tier, but he cheated on Susie Q. I mean, how could you do that to Susie Q? Susie Q is a high tier waifu, so I have to put him in D tier. And now we have Cesar Seppeli. I like Cesar. I mentioned him in my top underrated JoJo fights video. His bubble attack is cool, but I have to compare him with other characters now, so I'll put him in C tier just for now. And now we have Wamuu. Wamuu is a cool villain and he defeated Cesar as well. So I'll put him in CT as well. And now we have Lisa Lisa. I love Lisa Lisa. She's so stylish. I mean, look at her. And she's 50 years old. I would put her in B tier, but she doesn't have stand, so I'll put her in C tier. Now we have Kaas. Kaas is basically a god. He was unstoppable. He became so OP that Araki had to give the biggest ass pulls in JoJo to get rid of him. So because of that, he wouldn't be S or A tier. I'll put him in B tier. Now we have Jotaro Kujo. Jotaro is so badass that he learned Dio's ability during the fight against Dio and defeated Dio with that. Yep, no ass pulls there. He's such a badass. I would put Jotaro in A tier, but in other parts, especially in part 6, he was nerfed so bad that I have to put him in B tier. And now we have Kakyoin. Kakyoin is the first meme character we met. I mean, he said out loud that he liked Jotaro's mom. And for a moment, you could cut the awkwardness with a knife. I mean, you have to have guts to say that. Especially in front of her father, Joseph Joestar. Kakyoin is a legend. B tier for sure. And now we have Polnareff. Polnareff is the real protagonist of the story. They should have just named it Polnareff's Bizarre Adventure. Because every time Polnareff is alone, there's an enemy stand user, and Polnareff survived after getting chopped by Diavolo and had somehow survived till the end. You just can't get rid of him. He's definitely A tier. And now we have Abdul. Abdul is kind of a joke. He's the type of character that gives you all the advice but fails in everything he does. He was brought back just to get killed again. That's pretty lame, so I'll put him in E tier. And now we have Hol Horse. I just wanted to include Hol Horse because why not? He is one of the biggest trolls in JoJo. Just his stare down with Polnareff alone was enough for me to bring him into this tier list. So I'll give him D tier. And now we have Vanilla Ice. I like Vanilla Ice. He was a cool sub-villain. I liked his fight against Polnareff and Iggy. I also spoke about him in my JoJo fights video. So I'll put the link in the description so you can check that out. But anyways, his stand is so OP. I'll put Vanilla Ice in B tier. And now we are finally in part 4. Now we have Josuke Higashikata. Josuke is a good friend and he was the only JoJo that acted his age. I mean, Jotaro was a teen but he looked like an angry divorced dad with 4 kids. Josuke shows his emotion when needed and delivers as well. And he never says anything bad to Okuyasu even though he's an idiot. Josuke is definitely A tier. And now we have Okuyasu. Speaking of Okuyasu, this guy is probably my second favorite JoBro. He has one of the best stands in the series. Why didn't he just spam Sahando against Kira? He would have caught the air bullet had he done that. But never mind. I put Okuyasu in B tier for being a cool Joe bro. And now we have Koichi. I don't like Koichi that much because he's so stupid. How could he question Jotaro's experience with stands when they were fighting sheer heart attack? Jotaro, a man who traveled the whole world fighting various stand abilities, and Koichi, who has had a stand for like 2 weeks. I would put him in F tier, but he gets Yukako. I don't know what Yukako saw in him, but that is quite the achievement. So I'll put Koichi in D tier. Next up is Rohan Kishibe. Rohan Kishibe is one of my favorite characters in Diamond is Unbreakable. And Heaven's Door is one of my favorite stands as well. I spoke about it in my most useful stands video. I'll put the link in the description as well. But anyways, Rohan Kishibe is the manga artist our generation did not deserve. Rohan Kishibe is A tier. And now we have Yoshikage Kira. Okay, Kira is a good villain, arguably the best villain in JoJo. And I like his stand so much. Once again, it is also featured in this video. Link is in the description. But I love the way Kira says, "Kira Queen!" And he played Shinobu as well. He changed his lifestyle from Kira Yoshikage to Kosaku Kawajiri in no time as well. If this man wants something, this man will get it. Kira Yoshikage is S tier. I thought of including Hayato as well because he was an important character. So next up is Hayato. This kid had to experience some crazy shit. The way he took in his father's sudden changes and still somehow counted bites the duster was brilliant. But I don't know why he had cameras in his parents' bedroom. That was weird. But anyways, I'll put him in C tier. Alright, that's it for part 1. Part 2 will be out shortly. This is Boy Tavia and I'll see you soon.